Welcome to this .NET MAUI ListView tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to integrate the Syncfusion .NET MAUI ListView into your .NET MAUI application and design a newsfeed application. I open an existing MAUI application. Here, I have already configured the .NET MAUI ListView control and specified the source path to display news articles. To learn how to add the .NET MAUI ListView control to your MAUI application, watch the video linked in the YouTube card above or the description below. Now, I run the application. You will see that the title and its description are displayed. Now, I will show you how to display images in the newsfeed application. First, I navigate to the model class. Here, I create the image name property to store images. Then, I move to the View Model class and assign an image to each news item. Make sure that the images are already stored in the Resources folder. Next, I navigate to the main page XAML to wrap each news item inside a border within the ListView's data template. I define a border and apply a color to it, along with spacing around each item. Within the Stroke Shape property, I create an instance of the Round Rectangle class and set a value for the corner radius, which gives the border smooth, rounded edges. Within the grid layout, I define a border that holds the news image with a rounded border. To load images in the newsfeed application, I need to install the FF Image Loading MAUI NuGet package. I open the NuGet package manager and switch to the Browse tab. I search for the FF Image Loading MAUI package, select it, and then install it in my project. This library simplifies and optimizes image loading, caching, and transformations, helping create faster and more efficient .NET MAUI apps. After the package is installed, I open the MAUI program CS file and initialize the FF image loading library. Next, I navigate to the main page XAML and import the FF image loading MAUI namespace. Within the border, I define the cached image control and bind the image name property to the source. I ensure that the image fills the border and set its height. You will see that the image is displayed for each news item. Finally, to display the date, likes, and views icon in the newsfeed, I move to the model class and set the properties. Is liked to track whether a news item is liked. Views to hold the view count, and news date to store the date and time when the news was published. In the View Model class, I create random generators to produce random numbers for the news date and views. I store the current system date and time, which serves as the base time, from which I can subtract random values to simulate when the news was published. Next, I iterate through each news item in the news collection, generating a random number between 1 and 5, by subtracting a random number of days, hours, and minutes, and format it into a readable string. Then, I generate a random number between 100 and 500 and convert that number into a string. To display the like icon, I assign the isLiked property for each news item. I define a command for the like button, which allows users to like news items. Next, I create a method, doLike, to toggle the like status of a news item when a user interacts with it, and I call it in the constructor. I check if the clicked item is not null and store it in a variable. Then, I toggle the isLike property between true and false each time the method is executed. After that, I create a like icon converter class to modify how like icons are displayed in the UI. I check if the value is a Boolean and true. If it is true, I return the like icon. If false, I return the dislike icon. Now, I move to the main page XAML. Within the resources, I declare the like icon converter class, which is used to change the like icon based on whether a news article is liked or not. Next, within the data template, I define a grid layout to display the date, view icon, and number of views. I will create a button section in the fifth row containing three elements. I define a grid layout and add a border. I place it in the first column, align it to the left, set the stroke color and size, and give it rounded edges. Within the border, I define a gesture recognizer's property with the tap gesture recognizer class. Then, I bind the like action command, passing the current news item as a parameter. Next, I add a label inside the border to display the like icon. I bind the text property of the label to the isLiked property, and use the icon converter to transform the isLiked value into an appropriate icon. In the second column, I define a border, and add a label that displays the comment icon. Lastly, in the third column, I add a border and a label to display the share icon. Once the application is loaded, you will see that the date, time, and icons are updated. Let me wrap up this video. You have learned how to integrate the Syncfusion .NET MAUI ListView into your .NET MAUI application and design a newsfeed application. If you want to see this example's working code, download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also included a link to check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI controls. If you found this video helpful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.